Today I will be talking about exercises, foods and lifestyle changes that can help you lose belly fat and gain a flatter stomach. Belly fat is often referred to as stubborn fat because in spite of all the efforts, it doesn't seem to budge easily. This fat is in close proximity to the vital organs like liver, kidney and other digestive organs, and that's why it's a real health concern. Here are some of the lifestyle changes to reduce belly fat. It is important to realize that controlling insulin level is important in optimizing your weight. When your insulin levels increase, carbs are stored as fat. This makes it difficult for you to use your own body fat as energy. Refined and processed carbs like bread and pasta not only make you gain weight, but make sure you keep that weight on. By cutting out sugar and shifting to millets from grains, you can successfully reduce weight. Try to avoid added sugar when you are trying to reduce belly fat. Even hidden sources of sugar like dairy, juices, carbonated drinks, packet snacks made with refined grain contain a lot of sugar. Try to eat at least one meal sitting on the floor. This will help to promote digestion. Eat slowly and chew your food well. You must have a good digestion to reduce belly fat. Make sure you're not eating in front of the screen, as any distraction will come in the way of your brain signal that conveys you're full. Fiber binds with water and forms a gel, giving more bulk to the stool. Fiber helps to keep you full for a longer time and improves digestion. It feeds the good bacteria in your gut. Fiber also binds with the fat and removes it from the body. Some of the fiber-rich foods are berries, greens, millets, peas, figs. Include healthy fats like coconut oil. This is a medium-chain fatty acid and gets directly absorbed in the liver. If you do not like adding coconut oil to your meals, you can add it to your morning lemon water. So warm water with coconut oil 1/2 teaspoon and 1/2 squeezed lemon. This will help you relieve constipation too. But remember, you need to cut down some fat during the day. If something is healthy, it doesn't mean you overdo it. Other sources of healthy fats are nuts and seeds. Too much salt causes water retention and makes you feel bloated. So, cut down on refined salt and if possible shift to pink salt or rock salt, that is sendha namak. Exercise is the most important factor in shedding unwanted body fat and normalizing your insulin level. A factor that is often overlooked is your back muscles. Our core not only comprises of abs but lower back too. Back helps you hold yourself up and stomach in. So, having strong back muscles and abs is essential for a flatter stomach. You may include some back bending exercises to strengthen lower back, like bridge pose, also known as Setu Bandhasana, camel pose, also known as Ushtrasana, bow pose, also known as Dhanurasana. You also need to strengthen your hamstring muscles, which are located at the back of the thighs. Exercises which help to improve flexibility of hamstrings are forward bending dog pose, also known as Adho Mukha Svanasana, reclining big toe, also known as Supta Padanguttasana, head to knee pose, also known as Janu Shirsasana. Now, let's look at some of the effective abs exercises. Plank. This stimulates more abdominal activity than a regular crunch. Bicycle crunch. This is one of the most effective exercises when analyzing the muscle activity in the abdomen. Vertical leg crunch. This stimulates more abdominal activity than a traditional crunch. However, it is important to keep in mind that there is no single abdominal exercise that challenges all your abdominal muscles. You need to perform a variety of exercises that involves full range of muscles. To maximize your effort, make sure to include strength training once a week as a part of the exercise program. Intermittent fasting gives enough time to your body to digest your food well and regulates your insulin level. If not 16 hours of fasting, at least do about 12 hours of fast combined with early dinner. A good posture is extremely important. Whenever we slouch, our belly starts protruding and slowly takes the shape of the body. So, work on maintaining a good posture. Detox is of different types. Physical, drink with warm water, ginger, lemon and pink salt, which makes a good detox drink. Digital detox, maybe one day in the week you can keep yourself away from the gadgets, especially the phone. If not one day, at least half a day. This truly helps to relieve your stress. Emotional detox, stay away from people who stress you out. Spend some good quality time with your family every evening and during the weekend. This is so powerful. It gives you so much energy for the week. What does sleep have to do with a flatter stomach? Abdominal fat has a very rich supply of blood and has 4 times more cortisol receptors than other body fat. Cortisol is a stress hormone which is released in response to stress. Sleeping too less or more results in excess production of cortisol, which tends to store unused fat which is released by the body in stress response. Since your belly fat contains large amount of cortisol receptors, you may tend to gain fat in abdominal region when you're chronically stressed or having trouble sleeping properly. So, work on reducing your stress level and improving your sleep pattern. If you are looking to lose some weight, especially around your stomach area, do try this combination of exercises, food and lifestyle changes. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button.